So this is the video that you guys have been requesting, that I do a full review of Dere R9 Pro Laptop. First of all, I'd like to state that Dere R9 Pro comes in different configurations, including different memory, RAM, that is RAM, SSD, and also even the CPU configuration. So the specific laptop that I'm reviewing right now is Dere R9 Pro Laptop, which comes with 8 GB RAM, 128 GB internal storage or SSD, and Intel J4125, that is a Intel Celeron processor. So first of all, guys, we will look at the build quality and then we'll go to the technical specifications. Now let's start with the keyboard. The keyboard is full size, so it has the num keys, which is really good. I like it. And the power button is at the top corner. It's actually on the keyboard layout at the top key, and that is really nice. And then the keyboard, the keyboard itself is not really one of the best, especially for typing long. It doesn't really feel premium, and it is not really that great, except it comes with a keyboard cover. But it is good, it will do you the typing job that it's supposed to do, but you may not be able to type for long because the more hard, they really don't work well. Then when it comes to the trackpad is actually very good in size. It's actually big, very big trackpad or touchpad. And for this laptop, I've had problems working with the touchpad. It has been unstable. I've not had too many people complaining about the same. Maybe it's only my this laptop, but I actually use mouse 90%, if not 99% of the time, because the touchpad is not really good. So, and then when it comes to the chassis or the body of the laptop, it is full plastic. So the laptop is plastic all the way around. So, and then when it comes to the camera or webcam is actually an average one. It is 640x480, that is the resolution of the webcam, which is really average. You can do meetings, but it may not be that great. If you do Zoom meetings, if you are a guy who uses webcam most of the time, this is not a really great laptop, but it can do the job. It can actually, it can take your picture. Not so bad, but not the best. You can expect that for an average laptop or a budget laptop like this. So, and then when it comes to the screen actually is actually one of the biggest pros of this laptop. It comes with a screen resolution of 1920x1080. That is actually full HD resolution, which is a great feature of this laptop. I like it. I didn't mention at first, but this laptop comes with Windows 10 pre-installed, but the Windows 10 that is pre-installed is not activated, so you will need to buy a key to activate it. So I decided to just install Ubuntu, which is a free and open source operating system. that works well. It works well with Intel processors, and this laptop uses Intel processors, so it works well, and it's free. Everything is free for Ubuntu. So yeah, so that is it about the camera and the screen resolution. And then when it comes to Bluetooth, now we're dealing with hardware now. When it comes to Bluetooth, those are technical specifications now that you're talking about. Bluetooth version is 4.0. yeah, I did check mine. It comes with Bluetooth version 4.0. I can check. Yeah, Bluetooth version 4.0, which is not actually the best. It's not the latest, neither is it the greatest, but it does the job, especially if you want to connect to mouse, to a wireless mouse which uses Bluetooth only, because there's one that uses the dongle and the one that doesn't use a dongle. You just connect directly to the Bluetooth. So mine is one such. I don't use a dongle, I just connect directly. So it works well. What doesn't work well though is the wireless headphones or earphones which uses Bluetooth 5.0, especially if you're using Ubuntu. You know, Windows has very good drivers for hardware, so you may not experience the same problem, but if you're using Ubuntu, you might have problems connecting audio, especially if for lower Bluetooth versions, connecting audio to a Bluetooth device. So connecting through audio through the laptop to your maybe headphones or earphones, you might have problems in Ubuntu, but I'm sure Windows guys don't have such a problem. And then when you talk about the microphone is not the best quality microphone. In fact, I use it to record this video, and I'm sure you can hear that my sound is not really the best. It's not actually the best quality there. You can hear me. So I did record it intentionally so that you guys can judge for yourself whether this audio quality of the microphone is actually good. I mean, it's not that good, but it does the job actually. It records, and I'm sure you can hear me. So that is it about the microphone. Not the best, but it can do the job. And then now we want to check the memory. Like I said, it comes with 8 GB RAM, DDR4 at 2133 MHz, which is actually not so bad. It's able to actually run heavy applications that require moving so many files, and very large files like Android Studio. Like you can see here, I do have Android Studio installed, and it works fine. It does the job. The laptop does heat, especially if you're running heavy applications. It does heat, it gets hot a little bit, gets a little bit warm, but I've not found that to be a really big problem. It has never interfered with my working, and actually it is not so bad. So like I said, the RAM is 2133 MHz. That's the speed. It is, of course, that is DDR4 low power DDR4 synchronous memory. So like I said, it comes with DDR4 8 GB, but for this specific laptop that I'm reviewing, you will not be able to upgrade to any other RAM size beyond 8. So please know that you can upgrade to a maximum of 8 GB RAM and not beyond that. But if you're using a laptop, a Dere laptop that has a different processor, like I've seen lately, they have upgraded to Intel N5100 processor, which can support up to 16 GB RAM. Yeah, that one can support up to 16, but this one specifically has a maximum supported memory of 8 GB. So, and of course, like I said, the speed of the RAM is 2103 MHz, which is not so bad. And then we go to the SSD. It comes with 128 GB or 256 or 512. That means, of course, that SSD is upgradable. The internal storage is upgradable. You can upgrade to whichever size of storage that you want, up to 1 TB. So when we talk about the processor, let's see the processor. The processor is a Intel, like I said, it is Intel Celeron J4125, which has a base frequency of 2.00 GHz. It has a 4 cores, it is a quad core processor, and 4 threads, that means 1 thread per core, and it has 1 socket. Of course, Intel uses the x86-64 architecture, and that's not a bad processor, not so bad. 2.4 base, boost frequency is 2.7, that is the maximum frequency, which is actually good enough to handle most of the average user tasks that you will throw at it. Yeah, so that is it about the processor of the laptop. Then we can talk about now the battery of the laptop. So the battery is 5000 mAh, and that's found to last up to 8 hours, depending on what you're doing, especially for an average user. For light tasks, it will be able to go up to 8 hours. But if you are doing heavy tasks, of course, that will really go down to 3 or even 2 hours. So the laptop comes with 2 USB ports, 1 HDMI, and 1 combo jack port, that is, and of course, 1 microSD port, and 1 Ethernet port, which is actually not really bad. It is sufficient for me. I found that it's sufficient. And in case you have a problem, maybe I will advise you to, if you want to use all the 2 USB ports, then I'll advise you to maybe use a Bluetooth mouse like me, that doesn't need a dongle. So that's it, guys. I hope I've covered most of the things that were really really very important, and I hope I've made your work easier if you want to buy this laptop. I hope you will now easily decide. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to my channel.